Coming up next is Stephen Moore, also known as Mosquito Steve. Rory McIlroy pulls out of the Olympics because of the Zika scare. Stephen Moore has forgotten more about mosquitoes than most of us know. Steve Moore, welcome again to the Bill Cunningham Show.
Well, thank you. I got to tell you, I had no idea I was going to be on with you. I go to bed with you every Sunday night.
Well, where are you now, if anywhere?
I'm in Dallas.
Dallas. I'm big in Texas, no question.
You are big here, and I'm not kidding. I cannot sleep on Sunday nights if I'm not listening to you. It's amazing.
Well, I got San Antonio, Dallas, Houston are three of my top five markets, so that's good.
You are a great American, and I'm the second greatest American.
I consider each American who takes care of his or her responsibilities, who cares for his or her family, who loves her husband, loves her wife, who has kids, works hard, works smart, pays their taxes, has dirt under their fingernails, gets up every day to do a job, completes the job well, and come home at night. Those are my people. We are the ones, Steve Moore, that makes life happen in this country. We're not looking at the government for handouts. We understand what the Constitution means. We don't give a crap about Islamic extremism and what they want to do to us. We've beaten the Nazis. We've beaten the communists. They're simply in a long line of losers that we're going to beat.
Amen. Thank you for saying that. Amen. I agree.
Getting back to mosquito, tell me what you know about mosquitoes.
Well, so here's what's happened. So I've actually, boy, you talk about it. I've worked for 14 years for free just studying mosquitoes, what they do, and I study what products work and what doesn't. And the way I do that is I stand outside and I count how many mosquitoes land on me, and then I test products. I've tested a bunch of products I've developed. I've tested everybody else's products. I've had as many as 900 mosquito bites in one night just to prove that a product works or doesn't.
So tell me then. How much fear is there in Texas, but more importantly, in Cincinnati, Ohio? I'm here Monday through Friday, 12 to 3. How much fear should I have when I play golf this afternoon about getting the Zika virus if I'm not going to get pregnant?
Yeah, you shouldn't worry about the Zika virus. Honestly, the Zika virus is very, very mild. So most people, if they show symptoms at all, which most people will not show symptoms, if they show them at all, it's going to be really mild. It might be flu-like possibly. So it's only pregnant women that need to worry about Zika.
So why is Rory McIlroy being such a wuss?
Well, it's him and his wife. I noticed he said, and his wife are not going to go. And so I actually expected a little more fallout from this, and we might get some more, so it's not a huge surprise to me. And it's about misinformation. Most people just don't understand. They're afraid of something they don't understand. And so if he'd pay attention, he would know that there's really not that much danger in this for him.
Well, what about him? What if he would go to Rio for the Olympics, leave his wife back in Ireland or Florida, wherever she is, and then just go back? But I bet on other experts that say, well, if a man does that, he's got to use a condom for the next 6 months. Is that true?
Well, or not have sex. How about that? Oh, my gosh. What if we just withheld from having sex for 6 months? No, so the virus actually only takes about 3 or 4 days to incubate in a human being. So past 4 days, he's free and clear. If he comes back from there, even if he's had sex with somebody that's got Zika, he comes back from there in 4 days, it's gone. You know, it's a four-day deal.
Steve Moore, every few years I do this topic, it's different. We had the H1N1, the bird flu, and then we had Y2K 16 years ago. Well, I keep doing this scare tactics being employed by, all hell's about to break loose. So you're telling me the Zika virus is no big deal?
It's not unless you're pregnant. It is a big deal in some of the third world countries. Obviously, Puerto Rico, they're having a huge wave of it there. So the pregnant women there are in danger. Yes, absolutely.
Because your baby's born like a peanut head. Your baby's born with a
microcephaly.
That's not good.
No. Exactly. Now, the thing that we've got to worry about here in the United States is the West Nile virus and dengue fever and things like that. So dengue fever has actually showed up in the Keys. It's been in Texas before. Dengue fever can be dangerous. And chikungunya, which is one that comes over from the Caribbean every once in a while.
What's that called? Chicken what?
Chikungunya.
Chikungunya.
Yeah, and 95% of the people that get that show symptoms. So, like with West Nile virus, 1 in 100 show symptoms. With chikungunya, 95% of the people show symptoms.
And so if you are a woman of child barren age and you want to be pregnant and you're actively trying with your husband to get pregnant, you should be concerned.
You should be concerned, but remember, the most important thing to remember is 4 days. It just takes 4 days. That's what amazes me. So all the cases that are showing up in America are either people that have traveled over there and brought it back, or they've had sex with somebody. It's like, can you not wait 4 days to have sex? I don't understand it.
Now, I often go 4 weeks or 4 months. It's no big deal.
I'm not even going there. You don't want to know, because let me tell you something. A guy that studies mosquitoes has very few girlfriends, I promise you. So
I just got a text that said fear is the absence of knowledge. And so you
That's
fear something you
it.
Don't understand. So Rory McIlroy is rich and famous. He's got all the money in the world. So why doesn't he just say, look, honey, you stay here. I'll go to Rio, blame it on Rio. I'm going to go down there, play a little golf, and I'll come back, and we just won't do the wild thing for like maybe a week.
Well, it seems simple enough, and here's an even better suggestion. While you're there, wear mosquito repellent. Oh, my gosh, what a concept that would be. That's, you know, they're not even talking about that. But I will tell you, so this is really important. DEET, in all of my studies, DEET breaks down in 45 minutes. So, the label claims on most of these products is not even close to what they actually do. So if you're wanting protection longer than 45 minutes, I've found that DEET is not as effective. My product is actually more effective
what
than
is
DEET
it?
Was often. It's all natural. It's essential oil. It smells good. It's mosquito spray on repellent, and it's amazing. And so, you got to look at. You have to go on my website and look at the videos and pictures of me standing out counting mosquitoes. It's pretty freaky.
Well, one might ask Steve Moore, why are you into mosquitoes? What had happened in your life that caused you to research mosquitoes? Why would you let yourself be stung 900 times a night? Well, why do you do that?
Well, it started off because it was a business opportunity, but then I was fed so much misinformation, and I started studying up on it. I couldn't believe what I was reading. And so, I mean, people are going around saying, oh, it's a botanical insecticide that we're putting on your yard. Well, it's a very highly toxic poison. So, so I started studying them. And I gotta tell you, I'm as conservative as they come. I am not a tree hugger, but what I don't like is I don't like misinformation. I cannot stand, like, this is almost like when the tobacco companies were saying, oh, it's okay to smoke. You know, it's kind of like that. And then we got the chemical companies saying, oh, this stuff won't bother you. Oh, it's no big deal. It is a big deal. You know what? This is for our kids and grandkids. Of course, I'll never have kids and grandkids, but for all you guys, kids and grandkids out there.
Well, you know, one thing, I have a son. I got two little precious grandchildren. I'm going to go to Florida for a few days. None of them are, shall we say, of child-bearing years anyway. So if you're a kid outside and you're 11, 12 years old, just let it rip. Don't do anything.
If you're 11 or 12 years old, I would spray on repellent. I definitely would use spray on repellent. Just because we know that West Nile virus is here in America, and the younger kids and the older adults, West Nile virus can be extremely dangerous. So I got it in 2008. I'm a husky guy, I was sick for 2 months, but it didn't get hold of me like it does a lot of other people. So it's always a good idea to wear repellent if you're running outside.
All right, now what is your website, Steve Moore? Because I just got a text from a friend of mine, Wally Sweeney, who wants to buy your repellent. He says that he wants to use it as like an aphrodisiac. So what is your website if it smells good? I mean, Wally Sweeney doesn't smell good, so he needs it.
All right, it's mosquitosteve.com, just mosquitosteve.com.
And
you have to know how to spell mosquito, though.
Well, how do you spell it? I'm thinking maybe I'll try to spell it. Can I try to spell it and see if it makes sense?
That would be great.
Mosquito. M-O-S. Q-U-I-T-O.
That's it.
Is that it?
Even my bank put an E in there. So It's just amazing.
Mosquito.
I've been doing business with them for a year, for a decade, and they spell it with an E.
Well, you know, as Jeff Henderson knows, they're thinking about potato instead of mosquito. But I won the 8th grade spelling bee at St. Xavier Grade School. So Jeff Henderson, our news guy, can't spell mosquito. He puts an E at the end. But I spell mosquito M-O-S-Q-U-I-T-O, and that's it. Jeff Henderson told me there's an E. He's thinking about potato. I'm thinking about mosquito.
I'm definitely not potato, Steve. I look like a potato, though.
Now, as I understand it, the Zika virus only inhabits special kinds of mosquitoes. Not all mosquitoes have the Zika virus, correct?
That's a really good question. So the Aedes aegypti and Aedes albopictus are the ones that are carrying it so far. However, it's really important to note the Culex mosquito, which is the one that's prominent for carrying the West Nile virus, it has also been found with the Zika virus. So once it crosses over to the Culex, it's actually going to move up the states more because we've got a lot more Culex prevalent up north. And so the Aedes is most of it, mostly a southern United States mosquito. The Culex goes up north, and it will also at some point, it's going to carry the Zika.
All right, Steve Moore, do you have any questions for me about politics, sports, athletics, world capitals, geomorphology, something that's confused you over the years that I can help you with?
No. In fact, what I love about listening to you, Bill, is that you unconfuse things. You're so clear. It's so clear and makes so much sense. And I don't understand what's going on in this world. It is just baffling me. And I'm very, very nervous. I got to tell you, I'm really, really nervous that we're going to get a third Obama term with Hillary. And, Trump's not my favorite, but I'm anybody but Hillary. Anybody but Hillary.
I tell you, Steve, for those of us who care deeply about the country that are not on the public teat in one way or another, to consider the abject, horrible failures of 8 years of Obama protected by the mainstream media, now they're going to jam Hillary down our throats. And guys like you and I, women that listen to me that are involved in public issues, I'm not concerned with. But there's a large group of Americans who can't find their ass with both hands, who have no idea who the senator is from their district or their state or who the congressman. They don't know anything about life. They don't know when Jesse Waters goes into the world and asks people, when was the Civil War? You get answers 20 years ago. And who's John F. Kennedy? Nobody ever heard of the guy. You talk about Ronald Reagan. Can't spell him, don't know who he is. And those are the people that actually vote in our elections, which is how we ended up with Obama in the first place. It concerns me.
Yes, yeah. Well, they can't even name the vice president right now.
No, they have no idea.
It's just incredible. And so, yeah, when the Jesse Waters, it's scary when I watch. I love Jesse, but watching him scares me because I just cannot believe those people are our voters, and they are. And so, yeah, I think, look, I'm a religious man, and I'm praying a lot. That's what I'm doing. I do think that ultimately, you know, God's will is going to win in the end, and I think he's got better plans for us than we do for ourselves, that's for sure.
You know, Steve, ultimately we get the government we deserve. And we've always had special men come along during difficult times to occupy the presidency. In the beginning of this country, we had Washington and Jefferson and Adams and Lee and Rutledge. We had people like that. Then in the Civil War, here's Abraham Lincoln. At the turn of the last century, we had T.R., And then, even though FDR was a disaster during the Great Depression, during World War II, he said to the generals and the admirals, you run the war, I'm going to Warm Springs, and we won it. Eisenhower did a great job. Reagan, at the time the Soviet Union was falling, but we had Ronald Reagan. And now here we are with so many big problems, and for God's sakes, we got Obama. You got to be kidding me.
I know. The whole thing has baffled me. And then we brought him back in again, and that's what's surprising me now. It's like, surely we have learned our lesson, but evidently we have not.
Well, if he could run for a third term, he'd win going away. It wouldn't be close. And the media who told us when Bush was running for the presidency, it was really bad when George Bush, 43, raised a lot of money. That was bad. Now that Trump doesn't raise a lot of money, that's bad. So what is it? When a Republican raises most of the money, that's bad. When a Democrat raises most of the money, that's good. And I'm looking at the world. I don't know what world I'm living in. I just hope God is not distracted. Maybe there's something going on in Alpha Centauri. Maybe some other universe or planet's got difficulties. I want the old man to take a look at us. Save us. I feel like a Jew on Mount Sinai. Moses, come on down. Give me the commandments. I'm worshiping false idols. I'm having sex with dogs and cats. All hell's breaking loose, and no one's paying attention. I need Moses to come down from the mountaintop. Now, I'm not sure it's Trump, but whatever it is, it's got to be better than Hillary, for God's sakes.
Absolutely. Well, I can't help but think that God is working behind the scenes. We just don't know what he's doing.
I hope.
Know he's got a better plan.
I know he
hadn't forgot about us. He's pulled me through some amazing stuff. I've been almost homeless twice in the last 14 years working on this mosquito stuff. I've always had to have a second job. You know, you're not going to find many people that will devote 14 years for a passion for something that's important anymore.
Well, Steve.
I mean, everybody wants immediate gratification. And so, so he's pulled me through. He's saved my bacon, and I think he's going to save the country.
Steve Moore, once again, what is your website, if any?
MosquitoSteve.com.
Steve, I'll see you Sunday night live in Dallas.
I can't wait. Thank you, Bill.
God bless America.